Good morning, dear children. So, dear children, I hope you must have completed exercise 10.10, okay? That you have to fill in your book only, okay? So, yesterday I told you that we will be discussing exercise 10.11, okay? So, in 10.11, we have to find age and we have to find duration of months or duration of years in this exercise, okay? So, first question is, find out the number of days from 5 February 2018 to 16 July 2018. What we have to find here? Number of days from 5 February to 16 July of the same year. It is also 2018 and it is also 2018. Now first you have to write from February 5 to 16 July 2018. Okay. Then you have to make two columns of month and number of days. Okay. Here you have to write the months from February to July, okay? From February to July, you have to write February, March, April, May, June, July, okay? And here, you have to write the number of days of these months, okay? Now, here we have written the months from February to July, okay? And here, are there 24 days in July? No. But why I have written 24 here? Because there are 28 days in July, okay? How many days are there in July? Sorry, how many days are there in February? 28, okay? And what is being asked here? From February 5. 5 February is the starting point, okay? So, we have to subtract the dates that are before 5 February. We have to subtract 4 dates. 1, 2, 3 and 4, okay? From 28, we have to subtract 4. Now, how much? Only 24 days are left in February because we are starting from 5 February, okay? If we will start from 16 February, so we have to subtract 16 from 28, okay? If we are starting from 2 February, then we will write 27 here. Okay, so we have to start from 5 February, okay, here it is 5 February, so that is why we have subtracted 4, okay, 1, 2, 3 and 4, ये जो 4 dates हैं, ये हम गिन ही नहीं रहे, हम तो 5 तारीख से start कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, okay, तो for example, your school reopens from 8 February, so your attendance is from 8 February. The dates that are from 1 to 7, you will be marked as absent or you will be marked as null, okay? But the school session has started from 8 February, okay? So, the starting point is 8 February. We will not count the starting 7 days of February, okay? We will start from 8 February. So, similarly, here, we will start from 5 February, so including 5, there are 24 days in February, okay? And March is a complete month, so 31. April is a complete month, 30. May is a complete month, 31. June is a complete month, 30. And what is the final date? That is 16 July. So, you have to write up to 16 July, okay? Do not get confused when you are asked the starting and the final dates, okay? Now, you have to add these numbers, 24 to 16. You have to add these, okay? When you will add these, you will get the answer 162. So, how many days are there from February 5 to 16 July? There are 162 days from 5 February to 16 July 2018. Now, question number 2. Payal was born on 14 July 2009. Find her age on 15 August 2018. Okay, here you have to find out the age. Okay, what you have to find? Age of Payal. She was born on 14 July 2009 and we have to find her age on 15th August 2018. Okay, so whenever we have to find the duration of age, we have to subtract the bigger number from the smaller number. Okay, if we have to find out the age, so always we have to subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. Okay, so we have to subtract, right? Okay, you have to write date, month and year according to this. Okay, so what is the date? You have to write her date on 15th August 2018, 15th August 8, and year is 2018, minus when she was born. She was born on 14 July 2009. Okay, so date 14, month 7, July, okay, 2009. Now we have to subtract this. Okay, this is the formula for finding out age. Okay, you can find out your age also from this method. Okay, you have to write here that today's date. Okay, so what is date of today? That is, what is the date today? That is 17/8/2021, and you have to write here the day on which you were born. Then you can easily find out your age. So here we are finding the age of Payal. Okay, so now keep it in mind that the bigger number will always come here and you have to subtract smaller number from the bigger number. Okay, now you can subtract 18 minus 9, that is 9, and 0 0, 2 minus 2 0. Okay, 8 minus 7 1, 15 minus 14 1. So her age is 9 years 1 month and 1 day. Okay, 9 years 1 month and 1 day, it's her age. But you have been asked to calculate the age in year and days. Okay, you have to calculate the age in years and days. If you will do up to this, it is also correct. Okay, and if it is asked to find in years and months, or if it is asked to find in years and days, then how you have to find out? Okay, because in your syllabus you have to find out the age in years and days only, not in months. Okay, so how to find out the age in years and days only? You have to keep the years as it is. Okay, and here you have to find her age on 15th August. So how many days are there on August? 31 days. Okay, and plus 1 day, that is 32 days. Okay, so her age on 15th August 2018 is 9 years and 32 days. Okay, so let us revise it quickly. What you have to find out? Age of Payal on 15th August 2018. Okay, now how to find her age? First you have to put the bigger number or the day on which you have to find her age. You have to find her age on 15th August, so you have to keep 15th August 2018 above, and you have to subtract 14th July 2009 from 2018. Now you have to subtract it. 18 minus 9 9, 0 0, and 2 minus 2 0. Okay, so it is 9 years. 8 minus 7 1 1 month. 15 minus 14 1 day. Okay, till now it is clear? Now you have to find the age on years and days. How to find in age in years and days? You have to keep years as it is, and when you have to find the age in days, you have to look on the month on which year or the age is asked. Okay, so it is asked on August. So how many days are there in August? 31. Okay, so 31 plus 1 day, that is equal to 32 days. So her age on 15th August 2018 is 9 years and 32 days. Now question number 3. A farmer took a loan on 9 April 2017 and paid it on 24 May 2018. How long did he take to return the loan? Okay, so you have to find out the duration in which he returned the loan. Okay, so whenever we have to find the duration, we have to subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. Okay, so here first we will subtract the years. Okay, so what is the year difference? First we have to write the year difference, that is 2018 minus 2017. Okay, the difference is of 1 year. Okay, now we have to find out the difference in days or months. We have find difference in year, that is 1 year. From 2017 to 2018, it is 1 year. Okay, and now we have to find days. Okay, number of days in from 2017 to 2018. कितने दिन हो रहे हैं उसको लोन लिए हुए. Okay, so we have to subtract 30 minus 9. Why? Because there are 30 days in April and we have to subtract 9. Okay, from 1 to 9. We have to subtract these 9 dates from the month of April. Okay, because loan will start from 10th April. Okay, so we subtract 1 from, or we subtract 9 days from the month of April. So 30 minus 9 for the month of April, there will be 21 days now. Okay, and there are complete 24 days for the month of May. So 21 plus 24, that is equal to 45 days. Okay, so we have 1 year and 45 days our answer. Okay, so let us revise it quickly. We have to find out that how long it will take to return the loan. Okay, or how long did he take to return the loan? Okay, so first we have to find out year. It took 1 year. From 17 to 18, it took 1 year. Now we have to find the answer in days, not in months. So how to find the answer in days? Okay, you have been given 2 months, April and May. Okay, now how many days are there in April? Total 30, but the loan is starting from 9. But it is being counted from 10th April. Okay, so we will exclude 9 days from the month of April. Okay, now 30 minus 9, that is 21. Now there are 21 days in April for his loan and the whole 24 days in May. So we will add these 2 days, 21 plus 24, that is equal to 45 days. Okay, so he has a loan for 1 year and 45 days. Okay, so after this I will be sending you photo of this exercise, and that you have to do in your copy. Okay, do exercise 10.11 in your copy.